Financial Sense Insider is a premium subscription service of PFS Group. The following is a free preview of today's Insider interview.
Joining us on the program today is Martin Armstrong of Armstrong Economics. And Martin, the market has been fairly weak. We saw not a very stellar Santa Claus rally, which many were expecting. I think historically, you know, many analysts have said that even if the market is weak, you could expect to see the market see a nice bounce into year end. We saw that in October after bottoming late September, but it pretty much petered out and did not really see much gains into the end of the year. And now we've seen the market weaken even further into January, starting off the year pretty badly. So the question is now, where do we go from here? I know we've seen China really make a lot of headlines with their markets being down 7%, hitting the circuit breakers numerous days in a row, a lot of policy mistakes being cited there, Middle East problems. But want to get your take. Where do you think the markets are headed this year? And what are some of the main drivers that you're watching?
Well, you have to understand how actually the global economy functions. And capital tends to concentrate in certain areas. For example, Japan had it. It's like they say, everybody has their 15 minutes of fame. You know, China basically had it. They ended up with the largest reserves of any country recently, anyhow. But all these things tend to peak out and then the trend reverses. And so what we really have is a lot of things converging globally. Part of the problem is with Europe, the structure of the euro is an absolute disaster, and it's creating more and more of a trend towards separatists and things of this nature. So we have Greece going down, but Greece is just the tip of the iceberg. It's all Southern Europe, and Brussels basically really desperately trying to keep everything in place, because if the euro goes, there goes their jobs. That's basically really what it's all about. Then you have a war cycle kicking in. China is in an economic decline, which probably will not bottom out to about 2020. Japan is still fighting a 26-year depression, which is equivalent to what the U.S. went through in the late 1900s. And so the U.S. is the only game in town.
You know, so one of the big news items that we've seen driving the markets has been China devaluing its currency and this slow devaluation. Of course, that was the main thing that was cited when we saw that August correction. How does China devaluing its currency, what is the panic that's related to that? Why is this causing investors to sell stocks? Take us through the thinking of how that translates to problems abroad.
Hi, everybody. John Loeffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's financialsense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.